Every year, hundreds of birds die across India during Makar Sankranti. Why? Because of the thread used for flying kites. Despite the ban, during Makar Sankranti, people use nylon threads, which is coated with glass shreds to fly kites, and this thread leads to more than just injury, resulting in death of the birds. So, what is Makar Sankranti? The festival of Makar Sankranti is considered to be auspicious because it marks the first day of the sun's transition into the sun sign Capricorn or Makara in Hindi. It marks the end of the winter season and the beginning of a new harvest season. The celebration of Sankranti is incomplete without flying kites. Well, it sure is fun for you, but not for the birds who get entangled in these threads.
The birds, especially the black kites and the crows, you see, when they see a prey down on the ground, they come very fast, like a missile. They just go down to get the prey. So they don't see these invisible threads hanging around the trees. And when they hit at a high speed into them, they get badly entangled into them. So these strings are very sharp. So as the bird gets entangled and tries to free itself, so the more the entanglement takes place.
Now, if it's a cotton thread, they can easily entangle themselves. But if it's a silk or nylon, it not just harms the bird, but also proves to be fatal in many cases. In 2019, 102 birds died, including 57 black kites, 2 spotted owlets, and 4 white-cheeked barbet. In 2020, a total of 177 birds were found dead, which included more than 100 black kites. This data is only from Bangalore. The numbers are far too worse in North and many other states where kite competition is a major part of the festival. In 2018, 4,000 birds were rescued in Gujarat by the State Forest Department after the mass kite flying during the Makar Sankranti festival. A bird rescuer in Ahmedabad estimates that 2,000 birds are injured in the city every year during Sankranti, and about 500 of them die from these injuries. Sharp manja is hazardous not only for the birds but also for humans, including passerbys traveling on open vehicles such as bicycles, motorcycles or scooters. It also causes numerous injuries and deaths of children and adults every year. In February 2019, a motorcyclist died in Delhi after his neck was slashed by sharp manja. And in July, a 3-year-old girl died after a stray piece of manja cut her uncle's neck, causing the motorcycle to crash. Sharp manja also wreaks havoc on power lines. A single power line disruption can affect up to 10,000 people. Due to the continuous sale and use of Chinese manja, the number of deaths and injuries among birds have only increased, especially in 2020.
More so during the pandemic, of work from home, this has increased phenomenally. The kids don't have school, the IT guys don't have work, so they're all flying kites.
The National Green Tribunal in 2016 temporarily banned kite flying with Chinese manja, a thread coated in a sticky paste of ground up glass or metal. In response to an outcry over injuries and deaths caused by the sharp string, in 2017, traders wanted the government to lift the ban on manja, but the Supreme Court refused, saying that it's too bad for the environment. It is also a huge threat when it comes into contact with live overhead electric wires, leading to grid failure. Only traditional biodegradable fabric strings are allowed in India. But is the thread really banned? No. Despite the ban, it is easily available in the market. It is not only available, but also sold cheaper than cotton thread.
So the nylon manja is available at 1/3 the rate of cotton manja.
And not just the endangered birds, but even wetland birds have been reported to be injured due to the manja thread.
Species of wildlife have, you know, they have a lot to contribute to keep our city healthy and beautiful. And if even a single species being taken out of the whole thing creates an imbalance.
Even after rescuing the birds and saving them, some lose their ability to fly. The NGO has about 20 birds that cannot fly at all. They lost their wings in manja injury and have never been able to leave the shelter ever since.
A letter to the Chief Minister of Karnataka, citing what's happening, citing the statistics, and how harmful it is and how it will adversely affect the environment and the climate change, and what we got to do. We got to confiscate this, all this, and burn them in front of the shops which are selling them, and imprison them. Department and to the fire department. I wrote a letter to all of them. No response from any one of them.
In a world with a lot of people who believe in anthropocentric concepts, wherein they, you know, they feel entitled. They think human beings are entitled to live here and do, and they don't really realize the repercussions it could have on the wildlife. So all we could really ask people to do is to spread awareness as much as possible. Firstly, of course, not use it yourself. And if they do find someone who's using this, they can also go ahead and report.
Thank you so much for watching. Stay safe, stay logical.